holy Saturday birthday extravaganza again. We got two big birthday extravaganzas back to back. We are going to finish off these birthdays with three extraordinary gentlemen in our community, Wylie, Joel, and Colton. Happy birthday. Awesome to celebrate with this little piece right here. So have a fantastic day, and we will hopefully make that day extra special for you, okay? Before we get to the work set, let's talk about the warm-up. We're gonna take down some back scale and front scale just to work on some balance through that kind of full range of motion, five per side. Narrow stance squat for three reps at a 5 second tempo down, 2 second pause, 3 second up. So a little faster on the way up, but not much faster, all right? So make sure you're focusing on those tempos and your depth and position. From there, humeral glide to knee push-up for 5 reps. Again, just kind of waking up that upper body a little bit, getting primed up for some of the movements in our work set. And then we're gonna take down some sumo deadlifts for 5 a side, okay? Or 5 in general, so we'll talk about that as we get going. 2 to 3 rounds, we'll take that through. Then we'll move down and start playing with some dumbbells. We're gonna work on dumbbell hang power clean for 3. Again, working from either the side or between the legs. Into dumbbell pause front squat, 2 reps at a 3 second pause at the bottom, and then you're gonna finish off with anywhere from 3 to 5 thrusters. All right, so that full squat, full press overhead, working on that full range of motion. Once you're done your thrusters, you'll repeat on the opposite side, flipping the dumbbell over, taking it through again, and then move down into 3 to 5 broad jumps. And I'm gonna have some options for the broad jump as well. We don't need to make them big, but we are looking at maybe doing that 2-foot jump and that explosive kind of takeoff from the ground. So don't worry, depending on space, you don't have to have a lot of space to make these effective for what we're after for the movement, okay? 3 to 5 rounds there. And then we get into our workout. So the workout today is pretty straightforward. We got a nice triplet for you. 5 rounds, 15 dumbbell thrusters, 15 burpees, and 15 kettlebell swings. So pretty straightforward in terms of your reps. 15, 15 for 5, right? All the way through, take it down, all right? You can break these things up. You can play around in terms of the thruster if you only have 1 dumbbell. We're just looking at 15 total, so you can do some on one, some on the other, mix and match. It's up to you how you wanna take those down. Same with the swings. If you're doing a single arm swing, you can break them down, or you can use the double hand for 15 total reps. So lots of options to play with for the thrusters. Burpees are straightforward, but we'll have some different options on the bottom of the workout description for you. Okay, so let's warm up. Let's get you guys ready. All right, guys, let's warm you guys up a little bit. Let's get those feet underneath those hips. We'll take those arms big and tall up overhead. We're just gonna reach over to one side and then come back over to the other side. Come back up to center, bring those hands to the hips. We'll separate the feet a little bit. We'll just take those hips around nice and slow. Just wake up those hips a bit. Nice full circles, nice full range. We'll go the other way. Good, from here we'll come back to center, bring our feet a little closer together, take those knees around, nice and gentle. Again, nothing too crazy, we're just gonna wake up those knees, wake up those ankles a bit, we'll go the other way. Center, roll onto those toes, those heels, those toes, and heels. One more time, toes, one more time, heels. Plant those feet, big stretch. From here again, big side bend to the other side. Come back up, forward fold, touch those toes, walk up those shins. We're gonna come back down, planting both hands. We're gonna step back into our plank. Settling into that nice plank position, tuck the pelvis through, press the shoulders, hold for 3, 2. We'll take the knees down into our table. We're gonna gently inhale into that cat-cow crow. Roll up into the cat. Tilt and lift. And then roll up into that cat. Tilt and lift. And then roll up into that cat. Okay, from here, neutral table, let's set that hip, set the shoulder. We're gonna pull the right hand back off the floor. We're gonna lift that hand up towards the front. You're gonna come back down and then press it into the ground. Set the shoulder again, pull the left hand back, lift, come back down, press it into the floor. We're gonna do that again, right shoulders and press up. Curling the toes, we're gonna extend up into our down dog. Reaching back with those hips, we'll come back into our plank as we step our left foot up. Bring that hand, that inside hand to the front foot. Turn the torso towards that outside hand. We'll come back to center. Turn towards the outside hand to center. And then turn towards the outside hand. Back to center, plant the hand. Step back into our down dog. Just big reach through those hips. Come back into our plank. Step that other foot up. Inside hand on that front foot. Turn the torso slowly. Back to center. Turn and back to center. And turn and back to center. Plant that hand. Step her back. Up into that down dog. Big reach. Come back into our plank. And then tiptoe those feet all the way up. Roll ourselves up, big tall stretch overhead. Good big reach. And reach. Oh, come on down with those hands. Let's get you ready to go, everyone. If you'd like to pause the video, warm up a little bit more, please do so. We're gonna move into the first piece of the video, and or sorry, the warm up, and get you guys ready to go, which is going to be some balance force. We're gonna go through our back to front scales. We're gonna move through this all on one side first. The biggest thing is we want to make sure that we're not turning it into just a rock and roll right through. We want to focus on control. So Raquel's going to get settled in with her feet, working on where her balance is on that balancing foot. She's going to get set. She's going to hinge into her back scale raise. Hands can go where they need to be for balance. She's trying to keep her hip as square as possible as she finds kind of end range. Then she's going to come back through, and if she can, just bring that leg right through into her front scale. So she's going to settle in, lift the leg up, come back to center, and then transition back into her back scale. If you need to place the foot down in between reps or in between back scale to front scale to get your balance, totally understandable and totally acceptable. So please do so. We want each side of this rep to be clean. And balance is challenging. It's a really hard thing to practice and play with. So we have to listen to our body and give ourselves what we need, okay? So please make sure we're focusing on that. Don't worry about kind of just going right through and through. Take your time, settle in between each set of the rep, and just make sure each half is really solid. Really nice reps, nice and solid. All right, from there, we do five per side. We then move into our narrow stance squats. We're gonna work on just a nice tighter squat. So we set up our squat stance, then we step our feet in just a little bit or a lot, depending on where you're at your range. Squat mechanics are the same, all right? But those feet narrow, we're gonna really kind of take it and make it just a little harder depending on how tight those ankles are. So from here, Raquel's taking her time on the way down, working a 5 second tempo down to the floor. She'll hold in the bottom for a couple seconds and then a little faster rise up out of the bottom. So again, with the downward tempo, we're just trying to focus on a slower squat down so you can focus on balance, work on range, work on keeping that back nice and straight. That pause in the bottom again will give you that chance to make sure you're balanced in the midfoot, and then you can stand up nice and smooth, okay? So narrow stance squat, same mechanics as a regular squat, just a narrow foot position, and that could be anywhere inside your regular stance. Our next exercise comes down to the floor. We're gonna move through our humeral glide to knee push-up. So Raquel's getting set and ready onto the floor. Hands are at the kind of low position at the bottom of our push-up, so by our chest. She's going to pull her shoulders forward, so in that place where we don't want the shoulders to be. And then she's gonna pull them back, retracting them into that good position where her elbow and hand are gonna be stacked above her underneath and above each other. She's gonna tuck and squeeze her pelvis and ribs as she gets that nice hollow. She can take a big breath and then maintain. She presses up, everything rises together, and then again, she's gonna maintain that tension as everything lowers together. So she's lowering down to the floor, making sure that everything is kind of shifting in that same hollow. We'll do one more so you can see again. So Raquel again resets by pulling her shoulders forward, pulling them back into that good set position. You'll feel your lats kick on. She's gonna squeeze into that hollow. She's gonna find her breath and then
take another breath at the top to maintain tension, and then lower down, maintaining this good body position all the way through. Remembering, if this is a very challenging push for you and you know that you snake up, I just want you to think about that isometric hold at the bottom, about 3 to 5 seconds. All right, don't worry about how high you get, worry about the tension, and worry about this mid-back position so that we stay tight and stable. So Raquel would set, reset, tuck and squeeze, and then she's just gonna press into the floor, maintaining that tension, wherever you happen to press to, and then she just lower down, release, and do it again, okay? So 3 to 5 seconds of that isometric hold, and then lower, all right? Build that strength in that nice plank, and then allow that plank to get higher and higher as you progress through that push-up, okay? From there, we have one more piece of the puzzle, which is gonna be a sumo deadlift. So we have two options for this for you guys today again. Seeing as though this is just a warm-up to work on a little bit of hinging, if Raquel wants to position herself over top of that dumbbell with the dumbbell standing tall, she's just gonna take both hands and wrap it around the bell portion, keeping that nice tall body, nice solid position, and then she's just gonna stand it up, and she'll take it down until the dumbbell touches the floor or as deep as she can maintain position. But with the dumbbell at that kind of position, depending on how big the dumbbell is, should make it to the floor with, I don't wanna say relative ease, but with enough range that she can get all that full range of motion. Another option, if you would like to work that single arm sumo deadlift, all right, we were working that the other day with our dumbbell snatch workout. Raquel will just get set up with the dumbbell in between her feet. Slightly wider stance, so about a squat or just outside her squat stance. She'll take it back and down with those hips, keeping her chest up, and she's gonna either take it down to the floor or to where she feels comfortable. Again, the back position is what we're after, everyone. I don't want you taking it all the way to the floor if that means we lose that nice extended back position. But right now, Raquel's working a really nice tempo, really good, smooth deadlift, and all you're gonna do is give me about 5 reps, all right? So if you're doing a single arm, you can choose to do 5 per side, you can do 3 per side, 5 total reps, it's up to you. I just want you to start warming up that hinge a little bit, but don't overkill it, okay? It's just there to get those hips ready to go, okay? So as a quick recap for you guys, we have back scale to front scale for 5 per side, into a narrow stance squat, 3 reps at a 5 second lower down, 2 second pause, 3 second stand. You'll then move into your humeral glide to knee push-up for 5 reps, and then you're gonna move into your sumo deadlifts and whatever option you'd like to play with there, just to heat up those hamstrings. 2 to 3 reps. Pause the video, take those rounds down. We are gonna move into our next phase, which is just some dumbbell practice. So we're gonna work on some skill work with our clean and our thruster. Okay, so come back to us. We're gonna take you through this lovely piece here. So Raquel's got her dumbbell. We're gonna do all of this on one side of the body. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna get set up. You can either take the clean from the side or from between the knees, that's up to you. So Raquel's gonna take 3 reps at that hang power clean. So she's either going to hinge, taking that dumbbell to just above the knee, or she's gonna work that nice vertical high hang power clean. But Raquel's got a really nice flow with the dumbbell. She pulls back to the knee, she keeps the dumbbell close to the body, all right, as it comes down and as it comes up. It's not winging out in front, okay? Once she's finished her 3 reps, she's gonna go into a pause front squat. So she's gonna set the dumbbell up, she'll pause in the bottom for 3 seconds, and then just stand, working that really good squat. Something that's really important we'll talk about after, in between these sides, Raquel's gonna take that squat down one more time, keeping that torso up nice and solid, her feet are flat, and when she rises, hips and shoulders come together at the same time. All right, and then the last piece is 3 to 5 thrusters. So Raquel's just gonna bang off 3 for us, that nice smooth squat, and she's gonna use the squat to get her out of the bottom, or sorry, to get that dumbbell off the shoulder and moving into the air before the arm starts to press, and then she can relax. So the big thing is use that squat, you guys. This is not a standing shoulder press. This is a hybrid of a front squat and a push press. So we wanna use the momentum coming out of the bottom. Something that we were talking about in the front squat portion, just get Raquel to squat for me for a second. So Raquel has the dumbbell on her shoulder, she squats down to the bottom, she's holding that pause. And something that's really common for people to do is when they rise up out of a pause is her hips to shoot up first and kind of tips her body and then she stands up. Alright, so what we want to make sure that we're doing, we come back down, we maintain that tension, and we think about either our upper back, the dumbbell, our chest, whatever that happens to be for you, to move first, and that can usually help. But usually it's that happens because we start to disengage in the bottom, and then we say, and go, and then our hips all of a sudden start to come up first. So we want to make sure we're maintaining tension, and we're really focusing on that shoulder coming up at the bottom of the squat. Okay? So please keep that in mind. Focus on that. If you notice that tip is starting to happen, try that, and then work on a little bit of depth focus as well. So watch how deep you're going. After we repeat that other side, Raquel's going to take down some broad jumps. So we have 3 to 5 broad jumps. I don't expect you to do like 3 to 5 in a row, because again, we might not have that much space in the house. But Raquel's just going to live kind of in this space, roughly like the size of a yoga mat. Raquel's going to get set like she's going to do a box jump, except she's not jumping up, she's going to jump forward. And I don't care how far you jump. So if Raquel throws down a broad jump, she gets those arms going, she lands nice and quiet, she turns around, that's one. She gets those hips firing and going, she pulls back and go, good. If she's like, I don't have a lot of space, just kind of jump over like the dumbbell size. So she gets set, she does this little 2-foot jump, and she just jumps over roughly the size of the dumbbell, and then turns around, and then does it again. So it doesn't have to be far or long distance jumps to get the benefit of what we're looking for here. What we're looking for is that quick hip, that quick extension, and then that little soft landing. So we want to focus on those good knees. So I'll get you to do one facing the camera for everyone. So Raquel's just going to do one jump facing. I want you to watch her knees and that knee position as she jumps. She pulls her hips back, the knees go slightly out, then she takes off, and she lands, and those knees stay out, so she's landing in like a power squat, right? So we want to make sure that the knees stay out, the knees stay out, and the knees stay out, all right? So focus on those knees. I'm not looking for huge jumps here, even if it's like an inch or two, perfect. Focus on that quick hip and that nice soft landing. So from there, we'll have a quick little recap. We have dumbbell hang power clean for 3 on one side into our dumbbell pause front squat, 2 reps, 3-second pauses in the bottom, then 3 to 5 thrusters in that next sequence. From there, you'll repeat it on the other side, 3, 2, 3, or 5, and then you'll do some broad jumps, 3 to 5 reps, okay? 3 to 5 rounds, pause the video, rock it, have fun with it. Play with your broad jumps a little bit, see how they feel. Again, if you can jump the length of a yoga mat, that's awesome. If you can jump just a little tiny jump, that's awesome. Work those hips, work that back. Alright? We're gonna move into our workout movements for you guys. You guys can take a peek at the flow and then go from there with the work set. So pause the video, warm up, come back to us, we'll talk about those 3 exercises in the workout. Alright? So in the workout, what we have is a dumbbell thruster for 15 reps. So Raquel's just going to work on showing you guys a couple thrusters again like we did in the warm-up, except she's just going to flow right from a clean. So a couple things Raquel's going to do here. She's going to do a clean to thruster. So she's going to do 1 clean into 3 thrusters. You can fix that one. That way you can see your hinge. So she's going to clean that dumbbell, pull right into the bottom of the squat. When she comes out of that front squat, she's going to drive that dumbbell up. Cleans it, big press, and then she moves directly into her reps of her thrusters. So again, in the work set, that hopefully that'll be 15 straight, or 8, 7, who knows, whatever the reps happen to be, all right? But that's a really nice, smooth, efficient way of starting your set. If you're comfortable with that clean, right into the thruster. If you're like, no, I'm not comfortable with that at all, Raquel's gonna show you a power clean to thruster. So she'll just do a nice power clean to get the dumbbell up to the shoulder. She'll get breath. This way, if she needs to, she can adjust her stance, all right, into a proper squat stance. And then she just starts her thruster. She'll squat, and she'll press, she'll squat, and press. Good. So either one is fine. You do have to clean the dumbbell to get it up to the shoulder, so please make sure it's an efficient clean. But if you are comfortable going into that full squat clean, rock it, come out of that into that thruster. Okay. Our next exercise in the work set is a burpee. All right, so we have 15 burpees in this work set. So Raquel's just going to show you a burpee. Nice and smooth. She flows down to the bottom of her push-up. She presses up, lands with those flat feet, little jump. Then other variations again as well. She can come down, she can step back into her lower, and then she can either jump or step up into her standing position. That's up to you how you want to get there. Again, focusing on trying to land with those flat feet. All right, that's very helpful in the ankles and the knees. Squat thrust. Full squat thrust, your belt pops into a plank, pops her feet back in. Again, same idea, flat foot, comes up, gives us a nice little clap, yay burpee, turn a few times, or she can step back, jump back, she can step in, she can do any variation of those things as well. I know a few of you do some elevated burpees, so hands up on the couch, jump backs or step outs, awesome, using the ottoman, what's it called, coffee table, you know, that thing. you can use that as well. Just make sure if you are using something that's elevated that it's stable and it's not going to move on you, because unlike the push-up, the burpee's a little bit more dynamic and we don't want to be pushing it or shifting it around, okay? So lots of options for the burpees. Take it down. Remember, if you're using the squat thrust, hit that strong plank, and if you find that you're starting to kind of sag in the midsection, just take a little break, all right? Take a break and then continue on with the reps. The last exercise is back with the dumbbell or kettlebell. We go into our swings. We did these last in our last workout on Friday. You had one set of them, so you should be well ready for this work set. Raquel's gonna grab hold of the dumbbell by two hands at the belt. She's gonna work on that same kind of position she was in for the deadlift, so that nice hinge. And she's gonna let that jump that she did in the broad jump kind of do the work, except she's gonna keep her feet planted. All right, so we wanna think about that. Quick hip, all right, while holding on to that kettlebell or dumbbell. Good, nice, very nice. She can also hold it like a golf club, so she'll hold the handle by two hands. Again, this is going to allow you a little bit more control on the dumbbell. She's still using the same body position, all right? You might find that this takes away some range of motion, and that's okay, all right? Just because you have a little tighter grip, less range on that arm, all right? And the last option is that single arm swing. If you'd like to play with the single arm swing, I've been digging these a lot since we started playing around the dumbbell swing. You can take that as high or as low as you want, but we work on single arm at a time. The biggest thing with this one, you guys, is to make sure we're focusing on staying square in our body and not letting ourselves get pulled around. If you're choosing this option, you can choose to do half on one side, half on the other side. Do all on one side and then the next round switch. That's up to you. Just split the workup between both sides. Okay? Make it work for you and do what you gotta do. Regardless of how you're holding the dumbbell or the kettlebell, the body position and the mechanics are the same. So we want to use the hips and the legs to do most of the work. We don't want to be swinging and pulling with the arms. Right, we're overusing the arms. The arms are just guides. They're just kind of like cables. Not doing a lot of work in this one. They're just kind of keeping the dumbbell or kettlebell kind of close-ish to the body as we flow up and down. All right, so please make sure we're using those legs and those hips. If you feel the arms starting to take over, take a break, allow the hips to rest, and then flow right back into it, okay? So quick recap on this workout. We got 5 rounds. 15 dumbbell thrusters, 15 burpees, 15 kettlebell swings. Rock that for time, have some fun with it. Keeping the movements clean, that's our primary focus with this one. Good, efficient movement will keep you moving through this workout well. Rest as you need to, break down the reps as you need to get through those 15 reps sets. All right, pause the video, take down the workout. Good luck with this one, it's gonna be a gasser. Especially going from swing to thruster, that's going to be a tough little combo, so please keep that in mind. Rest as you need to. We're going to kind of lay down on the floor for a little while, break it down, give you a nice little cool down to end off your week with, and call it a day. All right, so pause, rock it, come back to us, and we're going to lay down with you. Okay? So hopefully you've had a chance to breathe for a little while. We're going to lay down on the ground. We're going to take a nice long stretch from finger to toe. Big reach, We're gonna pull both knees into the chest. Just give them a nice little hug. We're gonna lower those feet down flat, hands down to the side of the body, and then we're gonna take those hips up to the sky in that little bridge. We're just gonna hold for 3, 2, and then we're gonna lower. And then from there, we'll take the left leg up to the sky, clasping with the hamstring, or pull the toe back. And I just want you to focus on your breath. So trying to breathe into the belly, the low ribs, kind of that full breath. And from here, I'm just gonna give that knee a little hug, lower it down to the floor, take that other leg up, nice straight leg, clasp with the hamstring, pull the toe back, nice solid position here. Remember, our goal is to try and keep that leg straight and straighten out that leg before we start kind of pulling the leg towards the chest. We want to make sure the knee is nice and extended. We'll give that knee a little hug. Lower it down to the floor. Hands down the side again. We're going to take those hips up to the sky, holding. We're going to take the top of the left hand, place it at the low back. Top of the right hand, underneath the left. Shoulders are into the floor. We're going to slowly lower the upper body and the lower body down to the ground. Until we feel that nice sensation through the pecs, the traps, deltoids, wherever you happen to feel this one, and then just breathe. Find that sensation that's tolerable. Take those nice full breaths. If it allows you to move a little deeper, you can, but if not, just stay where you're at. Good, we'll rise up. Remove the hands, we're gonna lower down to the floor. Good, let's squeeze and lift. We're gonna hold that position. Take the top of the right under the low back, top of the left under the right hand. Same idea, shoulders are pulled back into the ground. We're gonna slowly lower the hips and that back down until we feel that nice sensation. Tolerable sensation, I should say. It might not be nice. If you can get all the way to the floor, awesome, take it down. If not, awesome, just take it to where you feel comfortable. And breathe. We shouldn't be clenching, we should just be breathing freely with that soft jaw. Good, rise up. Let's remove the hands, place them at the floor. We'll lower the low back down to the ground. We'll take that left leg back up to the sky, cross it over, figure four. Find that figure four that best suits you today. Feel that sensation and then just breathe. And on the exhale, we'll roll the leg down. Take that leg up to the sky. Give a little squeeze in the chest. Lower the foot, we'll take the other leg up. Cross the leg over, figure four, and then find that stretch on this side that best suits you. Just feel that glute, just kind of stretch and say, whew. Then breathe, focusing on that in-breath. Relax. Exhale, lower the leg down, take that leg up, give a little hug, lower the toes, heels together, opening up into that butterfly, hands can come into the T, just rock those hips back and forth, nice and easy. And from here, we'll come back to center, the hands can come down the side or onto the ribs, and we're going to squeeze into that butterfly bridge, so we're going to squeeze, lift. Holding in that position, and then lower and release, and squeeze, lift, and lower and release, one more time, squeeze, lift, and lower and release. Rock those hips back and forth, just gentle. Center and draw those knees together, give them a little hug in the chest. You can rock it up and down, side to side, little circular motions, square-like motions, triangles, whatever you want to make with yourself today in that shape, please do so. Besides that, I want to say awesome job today, you guys. Hopefully that workout was lovely for all of you. Right, and that heart rate got a little high. I can guarantee you probably did. Anytime there's thrusters or burpees together with a side of kettlebell swings, that heart rate's gonna go way up. So hopefully it all went well. Let me know how it went. Happy birthday, Wylie, Joel, and Colton. Have a fantastic day on your special day. Awesome stuff. We'll talk to you soon, you guys. Have a good one.